Okay, y'all, what we got here is some beautiful Wagyu chuck eyes from Boarri Craft, Butchery, South Staples Street, Corpus Christi, Texas. We're gonna use this Wow from American Pitmaster. So let's just go ahead and put some on. Flip them. And do the same to the other side. We're going to cook them on the griddle over a gas burner made by Gas One. So we'll go out back and get that started, and we'll proceed to doing this, okay? All right, folks, here we are again. Got the Gas One, got a charbroil griddle up in here, and we have our beautiful chuck eye steaks. I don't know how hot this is. I barely got it on right now. I don't want to overdo it, so we'll just take one and put it on there. And it's very low and it's doing well. Take another. Looks like we're only going to get two on there, so we'll go with that. Sizzling quite well, as you can hear. Or can you? Here, listen. I've never used this in this setup before, but I thought about it and I said, why not? Perfect. This griddle is flat on the other side, and this side has grates, so raised ribs, let's say. Oh, nice. We'll just let it go for a while and see what happens. And we'll turn them probably 45, and then we'll flip them and do the same thing on the other side. And I'll cook the other one later for the sake of time, because I know y'all are hungry. I know I am. Take a peek. Oh yeah, nice. Nice little grill marks. Heated up fast in like 2 or 3 minutes. It was put on there cold, and then I turned it on low. Heating up well. This is a highly constructed stand, and the Banjo burner is just awesome. Puts out 200,000 BTUs. That's enough to cook anything. Let's see what we got here. Woo! Looks good. Now to do this, I gotta take one off and then turn this one 45 and then put this one back on 45 like that. This is wonderful. You know, you can take this camping, this burner, to the beach. You can cook fresh fish on the beach, grill them like this. You can do seafood boils. You can make soup. You could boil shrimp, fry fish, whatever you want. But on this particular day, we're having grilled steak. And man, I'll tell you what. Smells good. This thing's outperforming itself, I tell you. Oh yeah. Okay, we'll flip it. So good you don't even have to cut the seams. Man, that is beautiful. Now it doesn't have grill marks like a grill grates. They're actually a lot closer together, and it almost is like grilling it in a pan, but just a little bit raised up. I don't want to push on it. Some people get excited if I do that. We won't do it, sir. It's cooking. Oh wait, Houston, we might have a problem. I think it went out. Yeah, it went out, but it's not any fault of the machine. We're in Corpus and it is windy. We just had a cold front come in, so no problem. You just carry this with you. If you see the flames go out, just hit it up again. No biggie, fires right up. It's got a good regulator, good steel braided hose. More than you can ask for, folks. I recommend it. If you want to get started with a propane burner, this is a good place to start. Why waste your money on something cheap that's going to fall apart? And like I said, this is sturdy. All right, so I'm going to take this off, turn this approximately 45, really 90, and do the other one. That's a sight to see. Neighbor alerts, anybody's jumping the fence. You gotta stay out here, man. In this day and age, people smell some food, they're like, hey, what's up? Stay back. Just playing. Anyway, I thank God I have this thing. It's really nice. And if you're in a power outage and you need to cook something, you can boil water, make coffee, cook eggs and bacon. I mean, one propane tank's gonna last you a while. You don't have to turn it up full blast. If you're boiling or frying, you might want to turn it up full blast to get the water hot or the oil hot. But just something like this, you don't have to do anything. Just cook, man. It's on low. Now it might go out, but big deal. Well, I'm taking them off, okay? I don't want to overdo these. These are thin. Ooh, hot. They're kind of thin. I'm going to put this last one on right there. Yeah, be careful when you get close to it because the heat comes around it. As you can see me jump. Because I was feeling hot, hot, hot on my finger, finger, finger. All right. Well, this I'm going to cook this one the same way. So by the time you see me next time, they'll be rested up. We'll start slicing them. And then we'll do a taste test. See how fast that was? I didn't. This is real time, folks. Alrighty, folks, here it is. Came out pretty good. Let's just commence to cutting it. This is Wagyu, remember. Cuts really good, if I can get a hold of it. Cuts nice. Chuck eye. That's how it looks. Cut more, at least over here. A little bit right here. All right, that looks pretty good, folks, right there. Cooked nice, it's about medium rare, something like that. So there's only one more thing to do, and you know what it is. Okay, here we go. Start with this nice little piece right here. Man, wow. That's really good. And I didn't even use charcoal. Can you imagine? Cast iron griddle. Came out good. And evenly heated with the gas one burner. So let's have some more. That is cooked so good. Man, you saw that took probably 2 minutes to heat up. That boundary burner is very, very powerful. I barely had it cracked, and it was more than enough to heat up that griddle. So I highly recommend it. Honestly, it's very high quality and efficient, and we're gonna have to do more videos. Eventually we're gonna do fish, boil shrimp, all kinds of stuff. But today we needed to do some steaks, because steaks are where it's at. You know that, folks. And I give a shout out to Gas One. Look in the description, you can find everything to go online and get their products. Also, I want to give a shout out to Boarri Craft, Staple Street's number one butcher shop, Corpus Christi, Texas. And they have magnificent meat. Those steaks were $6 each. They're Wagyu chuck eyes. They're awesome. That's all I can say. And that's about it. Oh, and shout out to Arnie Tex, of course, my homie. Thank you for the wonderful product. Wow and OG can be used on everything. You can look in the description for that too. All right then, y'all. Like, comment, share on all social medias. Tell all your friends and neighbors to come watch SAPO Barbecue. And until then, God bless you and adios, amigos. Hey, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. If you like the content here, go ahead and subscribe, all right? Because we'll be having a lot more videos coming up in the future. So thanks again. Tell all your friends, and we'll see you next time.